All right, guys, welcome back for round two with Scan. We will be on the play again, which is nice. Always nice to get the play. All right, well, we have Ragavan, Blessed Land. We got some Undying Spells, but no Elementals just yet. We will keep this. This could power out a turn two Fable, which is nice. This Fetchy is going to go get us a black sword or a swamp. Because that way we're set up if we do find a blood moon. Let's set the yield. We can't do nothing. Overgrown Tomb, Thoughtseize. Fatal Push, Cauldron Flare. Okay, so this is that new Abzan Samwise deck. Oh, well, we're gonna have to bolt that Cauldron Familiar. Let's take a look here. I bet this is that new Abzan Samwise deck. Yep, Rosy Cotton, Lannis, Gilded Goose. What the hell does this do? Investigate. Okay, well, I think we just take Rosy, right? Yeah, I think we just take Rosy here. Coco is a very tempting target, but the cat. Then they'll Gilded Goose next turn, probably. Just as a blocker for the Ragavan. Academy Manufacturer. Oh, I'm glad we got rid of that. Good lord. We have black mana up as a way to revive Ragavan if we need to. Probably plays the Gilded. Yep, there's the Gilded Goose. Makes a food. Did he crack the food to bring back the Cauldron Familiar? Not yet, apparently. There's Blood Moon. Do we just slam the Blood Moon? I think we do. He's got one food token for the Gilded Goose. We're going to not attack this turn. We want to have Blue up next turn because he might crack food, bring back the familiar, block, and then we can just Undying. It's kind of a weird line to take, but we're going to play around it just in case. Luckily, the opponent only has one colored source now, so he would have to sack the food just to have colored mana. He could Coco here. Assuming that's what he's gonna do. Yep, there's the Coco. A goose and a Chatterfang. Okay. Well, there's our second swamp. I think we just go for the Fable here. Would like to find a Bolt or a Terminate for the Chatterfang, get that off the board. Finding a Fury would be great. Well, we'd need a red source to go with the Fury, but we'll probably pitch at least one of these Undyings to Fable next turn. We are still keeping them off of color mana. They've only got one. We're going to need the opponent to make a decision here. What was revealed here? So we know that the Gilded Goose, Cloaked Company's gone. They're running Gigantha as a companion, so I could see them all. I could almost see them going for Gigantha soon. Because he makes mana. Let's see. So he sets this. Then he can't play. The opponent try to get in with the Chatterfang. No. Does not want to go shields down yet. Let's see what we draw. Grief. We are no longer discarding to the Fable. Cast Exile the Undying spell. A spell that's actual undying. Let's take a look at the hand here. This Menace is going to be nice. Let's take the let's take the Farseek. And then bloop. Generate the Grief. We want to take the Lannis or the Cauldron Familiar. I feel like we take the Lannis here. It has the most potential to go wrong, I think, of the two. He's already got a Cauldron Familiar in the graveyard, so. And then next turn, we flip the Fable. Turn after that, we can start copying Grief. Every turn. Cracks the Clue for green. Oh, creates the food token to make another squirrel. Okay, so opponent's just going to try to flood the board with squirrels, so that's fine. Or he wanted to, well, I guess he cracks the food token to make a food token, so he doesn't want. Oh, go away. Another goose, good lordy. Well, in just a moment, he's going to have plenty of blockers for this Grief. Wouldn't hate finding like a Douthi Voidwalker here. Once we can start copying the Grief, then we'll just start swinging with the copy. Making him block that. He'll lose two creatures every time. Still hunt a Terminate here. That's not a Terminate, that's a land. What's he doing in our draw step? Sacrifice X squirrels. Okay, kills the Grief. That's fine. We just make goblin tokens instead. I don't even think we want to play this land yet. Maybe we do. So we draw a Grief all. If we draw a Grief next turn, we play the land. If we draw a Fury, well, we're still one land short anyway, so we'll just play slow, leave up a card. This is definitely going to be a Hitsugu matchup, though. It destroys Cauldron Familiar, destroys the Gilded Gooses, destroys all the Scroll Tokens. If the opponent wants to get frisky, no. Do we draw? Come on, just another land. Come on now. Alright, we're gonna play the land because now if we draw a Fury next turn, we can play it. We should, Oh, it's not really. We'd be getting treasures, but that's it. Making tokens, making copies of the goblin, but we're gonna do it now, actually. Because it goes away the next end step. Another land. We only run 19 lands. Come on now. We've seen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so maybe not too bad because we've. 6. Plus, we pulled another one out. Alright, let's get in with the goblin here. At least we get our treasure token that way. It's gonna go away anyway, so may as well just do it. It's gonna just go block with Chatterfang. Yep. It's a kind of a may as well. You know, get the treasure token. I can attack with your Gilded Geese. Copy, because why not? Come on, Fury. Feign Death is kind of nice. If he wants to try this Chatterfang trick again. Oh, we should attack. Man, getting this habit of hitting the okay button so many times. He wants to try to. We could swing in with Ragavan too. Yeah, we might do that next turn actually. Swing in with Ragavan. Now we could Feign Death the Ragavan. Make it a lethal attacker against Chatterfang. Fury, there we go. Four, and just put one there, and put it scoops up. All right, that was a perfect hit, honestly. Plus we had a mana up to copy Fury, so we would have just pretty much wiped his entire board. All right, so Unlicensed Hearse is tempting. We might do that. Bring in the Magus as well. Opponent's light on creature removal, but he is green, so he probably has Force of Vigors in the sideboard for Blood Moon. So the Magus comes in, basically to adjust for that. Fatal Pushes can come in. What else do we want? Turok's kind of tempting, but he's mostly green. Unlicensed Hearse maybe turns off the Cadavan deal, but we're already bringing in a lot. That's bringing in 6 cards. How much can we afford to cut? We want the Douthis. We want a lot of this. How much can we afford to cut? I go down fable. If we go down 2 fables, go down 2 Spyros, go down a grief, go down a Douthi, like that. Or do we keep in the Douthi as the graveyard hate? Go down a Ragavan. I think I like that a little bit better because the Tsutsugu, if we land it, is going to kill the Ragavan anyway. So we're going to run it like that, see what happens. If we lose this game, we might reevaluate. Because there's the risk of diluting our deck, and we're just going to draw all this, sideboard stuff that. Holy hell. If this had one more land, it would be a snap keep. And we got removal, Hidetsugu, Blood Moon, everything we need. I'd love to keep it. I just cannot justify it. Right, this is keepable. We got 2 lands. We got Undying Spells. We need another. Oh, I guess we don't need another red. And we got the Unlicensed Hearse. So, what do we put into the bottom? Put the Undying Evil to the bottom. We're gonna slow play the hell out of these Furies. Let him build up a board. Thoughtseize? Oh, okay. Rude. Who actually plays? Oh, I guess people that play the stupid Lord of the Rings cards play it. Alright, well, there's a Blood Moon. So I guess we could get the Blood Crypt here, because we will need a red source eventually. No, we would not like to pay 2 life. We play the Unlicensed Search next turn. Hopefully we find Killigan's Command to get rid of this. But he's got a plane, it's good for him. Far Seek. He's going to get another basic, probably a basic forest, making our Blood Moon a lot worse. His basic swamp. Okay. I hit you. Okay, come on now. Spyro. If we find another land, that'll be good. Find another land and hit Tsugu, maybe. It blows up the stone. So maybe we evoke Fury just to blow up the Chatterfang. Yeah, I think we do. We think we Blood Moon. We're gonna evoke this Fury because we want the Spyro. Kill Chatterfang. Let's get off the board. We lose our Fury, but we've locked down some of their mana. They still got red or black and white, but they don't have green yet. A lot of their deck is green. We saw so much green out of their deck last game. And now they can't even cast Gilded Goose to get green off the food token. There's a Cauldron Familiar. That's fine. There's Rosie. I'm gonna start eating graveyard here in a moment. We draw Thoughtseize, we're not gonna play it, we're just gonna play Spyro. Discard these two, see what we draw. Alright, we get land and grief, but we don't have a second black source, unfortunately. Still no green source for the opponent, which is good for us. Maybe you create a token. Okay. Do we start eating our graveyard? I think we do, actually. We don't want this. I mean, we don't really play out of our graveyard too much. And this means Hearse can kill these guys. Not like a rebirth. Alright, we need to start getting something here. We'll just keep going. Neither side is doing too much, just like the last game, but finding another Fury. Well, we could play the Rebirth next turn as a land. Let's see, let's just keep eating our graveyard. That makes this thing a 5/5, yeah. Still no double black, unfortunately. Play the Mire. Do we just want to activate this and start swinging? I really don't want to because they could just chump block and then bring it back. They can only do that once, though. Yeah, let's do that. Let's crew two. Let's get in for five. It'd be cool if this thing had vigilance, but that'd be so busted. Now, there's the chump block, so they can bring it back again. Yep, there's the activation. That's fine, but he's out of food. There's a basic forest, so that sucks. Here's a gilded goose. No, Coco? There's Coco. We should have evoked the grief. So you get two tokens, two triggers, it's gonna activate Rosie. And the stone killed us here, man. Blood Moon didn't help us too much either, but makes it a 3-4. Still kind of tempted to evoke. If we don't draw the black source here, I'm still kind of tempted to evoke the grief. No, that's not a black source. Man, a fury. Draw. Only got two furies left, unfortunately. Oh, hell. Still kind of tempted to evoke the grief just to see what the hell's going on in our opponent's hand. Yeah. Let's do that. I want to see what's going on. We're not going to be hitting double black anytime soon. Take a look. Scurry Oak. Yep, Scurry Oak's gone. Nope, not letting you keep that Scurry Oak. Scary Oak, more like. Yeah, because Rosie and Scary Oak just go. He was actually going to go infinite next turn. So good call on evoking that grief. I mean, I don't think we're winning this one, but plays the Gilded Goose, gets a couple more counters. Counter on Lilness, I'm assuming. Yep, there's the counter on Lilness, makes it a 4-5. Makes it a 5-6, yeah? Please get in. I'm begging you to get it, to swing in with that. Cracks Clue. Let's not get in. Oh, damn it. I missed the ends. I was gonna get that, but oh well. Let's see if the opponent draws, see if they did anything. We got the mana. We got the mana. I mean, Hidetsugu would be great here. Blow up half their board. Another Coco. Yep, gonna keep, Outland Liberator, too. Yeah, I think we're done now. He's gonna get in, he can just obliterate us now. Outland Liberator is gonna kill the hearse, so we will scoop this one up. That could have gone better. That stone really fucked us in the beginning. Not being able to effectively evoke our stuff was unfortunate. I don't really think we want to change anything per se. I think we just run it back. They had a lot of hate for us there. Drew a lot of hate cards. They had their infinite combo. We luckily got rid of it. Let's run it back. I don't think we want to make any changes. Still got the four Furies because we do want to wipe the board when we can. Headed Sugu. Still kicking myself over that first hand. Maybe if we had kept that. It's just one land without a red source. We had all of our outs, but who knows where it would have gone. We will take the play, yes. See what we can get. Not having double black when we Blood Moon was kind of unfortunate, too. Alright, yeah, we're keeping. We are keeping. We got Fatal Push. We got Grief. So, let's do this. Gonna get a Blood Crypt. We can get rid of Grief, because if we draw a second land, we can play this Stealthy and start hating on the graveyard. Rosie, Fatal Push, Viscera Seer. Do we take the Fatal Push? Because Fatal Push kills Grief. He's got redundant Rosies. Viscera Seer goes infinite with the cat. We gotta take the Fatal. We gotta take the removal, right? Oh, damn it. Oh, I'm an idiot. Oh, that was a punt for the ages. Good lord. Yeah, I think that punt's going to cost us this entire game. I can guarantee that. Well, let's just play the Malkier Mire. Thoughtseize the opponent. Take Chatterfang. No Chatterfang for you. Next turn, we'll probably just run out the Douthi. You got Terminate plus Fatal Push for anything pesky. Opponent doesn't have black yet for the Viscera. Alright, well, there's a Headed Sugu, which is going to be really, really nice when we find another land for it. Play a cat. Play a black source. Oh, he's sitting on over here. Rosie, I got basic planes, that's fine. There's a black source. Still not running out that Viscera Seer. I'm assuming he knows we have removal. Alright, Castle Lockwain is nice. Not playing anything this turn. But now we got Fatal Push plus Terminate plus Headed Sugu. So this is going to get nasty really, really quickly. As long as nothing goes horribly, horribly wrong. Have you found a collected company yet, opponent? No, you have not. Opponent is really saving up. They're not playing anything. Well, there's a basic swamp. That's always nice. That means we can Blood Moon eventually and still have our removal up. We could castle here, but I really don't want to pay for life. There's the Rosie. Makes a foodie. Now, if he goes for the Viscera Seer, we'll probably... He's not going for the Viscerous here. So let's just kill Rosie now. Bloodstained Mire. Let's go get our second swamp here at some point. Make us a little bit Blood Moon proof. Let's keep chipping in. Basically, we're gonna hold this hit at Sugu unless just see if things do get out of hand. I'm gonna play a second Rosie here. There's a basic swamp. What are we doing here, opponent? Three, Rosie number two. Yep, Rosie number two. That's fine. Mix food. You go for the Viscerous here. No, you don't. Still don't go for the Viscerous here. This time I think it is actually worth. Just need to draw something. I'll draw a Blood Crypt. That was not worth. We bolted ourselves for a Blood Crypt. Let's get the swamp. So we draw. I guess we could have, no. Let's terminate that, Rosie. Luckily, we drew all of our removal this game, unlike last game. This deck is not huge on removal. Fury is a big chunk of the removal in this deck. Let's see if Douthy Voidwalker can go all the way! Hating on the graveyard really well. Still got Fatal Push up if he plays a Viscerous here. Oh, we should have actually Fatal Pushed Rosie last turn on their end step, but we didn't. Okay, well that's gonna die. In response to Rosie, we will kill your Samwise. He wanted that to be able to pop the Chatterfang back, right? Unfortunately, we're not doing that. I'm almost tempted to hit it Sugu here. Oh, I actually might now. So it goes down to one card in hand. I just put the token, I just put the counter on the Gilded Goose. This couldn't go in. A lot better for us, honestly. We're gonna hit a Sugu here. Wipe away all these food tokens. Want a bolt. Give me a bolt. That's a Spyro. But we are gonna hit a Sugu now because we can't play the Spyro without losing the hit a Sugu. So kill the Gilded Goose and all these food tokens. Exile his graveyard. Next turn. Get in with the Douthy. Shadow means Rosie can't block it. And the next turn we'll probably just go for the Spyro and start getting in. Draw some more cards. I think Douthy could go all the way here. He's not gaining life with those food tokens, so... Collected Company. Could put a damper on our plans here. We'll see what he hits. That just went infinite. Son of a... He hit the infinite combo off the Collected Company. Wow. Yep, that's what could go... That's what could have gone wrong. We were very close. That should have won that game, really. But yeah, he top decked the Collected Company because the Viscerous Seer was his last card in hand. And then hit the Scurry Oak combo. So, good game. Well, that was a little unfortunate. Like I said, that should have been a win for us. We had pretty good control for most of that game. But oh well. See you guys for round 3 in just a moment.